I am Van, and we are all the LFR family, man. How y'all doing? Hey, for everybody that's not already LFR family, I'm gonna need for you to hit that subscribe button right now, Jack. Yeah, do that for me, man. It's not gonna cost you nothing to do that, bro. All right, I've been getting a lot of suggestions saying that I should check out Eminem's song "Believe." Believe, and I'm gonna be frank and honest with you, bro. Although I am a fan of M's, I have not heard this song before. I mean, because I look at it like a grocery store. Sometimes when I walk inside the grocery store, I walk right past the vegetable aisle. I walk right past the snack as soon as you come in the door. Sometimes they have some Ritz crackers up. They have some Oreo cookies. They have some, little Capri Suns, whatever. You know what I mean? And they have flowers over to the side. I don't get anything when I go to grocery stores, all I'm saying. So sometimes when I checked out some of our Eminem's old music, when his music dropped, I go straight for the stuff that was hot. And if the beat caught me right off top, boom, I was in there. Or if they talked about it all the time on the radio, boom, I was in there. But Believe wasn't one of them. But everybody keeps saying, man, check out Believe, check out Believe, check out Believe. So that's what the hell we're gonna do. And we're gonna do it in a way that's not really my style, as far as with the monitor on the screen and all that other stuff for you guys. But we're gonna do that anyway because we're trying something different. Trying to do things a little smarter. That's pretty much it. We still gonna have some fun, all right? But y'all, let me know what y'all think in the comments below, and let's get it. He started off the top talking about, I started from the bottom like a snowman ground up, because that's how you build a snowman. Then he said round Chuck, then still put hands on you like round Chuck. Like, when you seasoning the meat and you cleaning the meat and you trying to shape the meat just in case you want to make some burgers from deer, some deer meat burgers, some venison burgers. Oh my God, y'all ever had venison burgers? Oh my gracious. All right, come on, let's go back just a little bit. All right, come on. Staying round ducks is how I spend time. Sucker free, confident side. Such a breeze when I pin runs. I just got the air about me. Like wind chimes. Bruh. Such a breeze when I pin rhymes. I just got that air about me. Like wind chimes. I just got that H-E-I-R. That air about me. That A-I-R about me. Like wind chimes. That's how you know when the wind is blowing outside, because you got the wind chimes out. I just got that air about me. Okay. This ain't gonna be no long video, bro. Already, I can already can see that, he started off already, man, with the bars. All right, let's go. Like wind chimes. Hold on, whoa, 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 hold on, hold on, hold on. All right, y'all almost got by me. Y'all almost got something by me. Okay, let's go. Okay, 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 okay. All right. He said, I'm giving them pounds. Like, he talking about his neighbors that once didn't fuck with him. But now they see that he blowing up, and everybody like, hey, what's going on, Mr. Shady? What's going on, Mr. Slim, Mr. Eminem, Mr. Marshall? How you doing, bruh? So he giving them pounds. Boom, boom. What's going on? And then he said, I'm upscale now. So I'm giving them pounds. I'm upscale now, and I'm living in a nice gated community. Guess it means I'm way in the sky. So I'm giving them pounds, like pounds of coke, pounds of weed, like you're on a scale. You're on a scale with the pounds. Huh? Follow me. You're on a scale with the pounds. Guess it means I'm way in the sky. That means I'm sitting up high like, yeah, I done made it. or I'm high like, yeah, man, this is out. This, that's good right there. I like that. Or I'm weighing the pounds of coke, the pounds of material, the pounds of bars. Like, that's a whole drug. Okay. I think I did a little too much with that. Let's go. But I still remember the days of minimum wage for general labor. Welfare recipients is a minor. Look how government assistance is major. That was me, bruh. I grew up in the system too, bruh. I grew up in the system too, man. He just telling you his story, bruh. That's all. That's all he's doing. All right, let's go. Since it's a minor, look how government assistance is major. Adversity, if that first you don't succeed. Uh-huh. Put your temper to more use, because being broke's a force. Adversity. If at first you don't succeed, man, try again, man. For real, bruh. Try again, man. All right, I've been in talks with some people that are YouTubers, man, and they sounding like they ready to call it quits, man. I'm like, man, fuck that. You think all these other big wigs out here on YouTube, these other YouTubes called it quits? Nah, man, they kept it going. At first, you don't succeed, try again, or try another way. Something. Don't stop though. What? That was a whole explosion bar. Like, he's talking about everything that you can light flames to. And then he bring that back. Because he's giving people inspiration at the same time. But he's telling them how, man, when you come from the bottom, you just gotta ignite that flame and go harder. But then he comes back to it and say, I grew up on wick. You know that little, the end of a bomb? You like that, Jane? The wicks inside of the candle, those are wicks, right? The little brown pieces that stick, the little three pieces where you go to. Yankee Candle got some of the best candles. Oh my God, I need to be sponsored by Yankee Candle. Man, they got my house smelling amazing. Got it smelling amazing, bruh. But yeah, man, that's tell you how you tied it all. Oh, okay, hold on 1 second. The whole thing was about bombs. Anyone who thought I was done, not bitch, not white spot, lights back on top, my fate is yours, you still believe? Anybody thought that I was done? Hell nah, bruh. What you thought took me out, that made me stronger, man. That made me stronger, bruh. I like this. I like this joint, bruh. That sound like him, bruh. It sound like praise don't fuel him. Praise don't fuel him. Love don't fuel him. He's just a different animal, man. He grew up in a certain way that he's like, okay, all this adversity, I'm just gonna use this as fuel. And as much hate as he gets still to this day, that's why he's still pushing forward as hard as he's going. Like, we've never seen Eminem spit like this before, ever. This dude, man, we didn't even think that there was another level he can go to, but he's using all that hate as fuel. Like, man, yeah, I'm still here, bro. I'm still here. Wow. Wow. And he said, I'm gonna spend my whole existence making sure you don't live this down, bro. You ain't believe in me? Watch this. I'm gonna make you eat every bit of your words, man. Hold on 1 second, one second. So you might
right when I think it over twice. When you retards can roll the dice, but beef will at least cost you your career.
Oh, whoa. Hold on 1 second, bro. He said, man, you retards can roll the dice. Ja, MGK, Benzino, anybody out there, go ahead and roll the dice. Because even my cheap shots, even if I don't come to you directly, I ain't going to throw no sub, but I'm going to just smack you every now and again just to let you know I'm paying attention. But even those cheap shots are overpriced, man. Wow. Okay. Let's go.
Beef will at least cost you your career because even my cheap shots are overpriced. But this middle finger's free as a bird. New four-headed bird.
Nuke warhead at birth. Hugest forehead on earth. nuke warhead at birth. End of the tunnel, so people are always looking at me when they're going through it. You can't imagine being that family member, man, being that friend that everybody's always coming to when they are going through something, bro. Not realizing you're going through your own sugar honey iced tea. Wow, I'm that tunnel that people are looking at when they're going through. I'm that light at the end of the tunnel when people, sheesh. And it could also mean, you know, don't go to the light. To all the people that keep on trying M's pen, stop moving towards the light, because he is the light at the end of that tunnel. And he's going to snatch your soul, bruh, and end your career. Going towards the light means you about to die. Don't go towards the light. He's the light at the end of the tunnel. Wow.
Do it, but I just get so into it. I was there consoling you when no one knew it. When your situation showed no improvement, I was that door you walked over to it. I'm the light at the end of the tunnel, so people are always looking to me as that
going through it.
When that tunnel vision is unclear, shit becomes too much to bear. Since cleaning out my closet when I was having trouble with the snare.
Since cleaning up. Since cleaning out my closet, I was having trouble with the snare. Hey, bring me my, give me my snare in. Give me my snare. Bring, what? Hey, Dre, where's my snare, bro? Give me my snare, bro. I remember that joke. I'm cleaning out my closet. In the beginning, he was like, okay, where's my snare? That's tight. Okay, hold on a second.
Right. So when you were new and newest, when your situation showed no improvement, I was that door you walked over to it. I'm the light at the end of the tunnel, so people are always looking to me as they're
going through it.
When that tunnel vision is unclear, shit becomes too much to bear. Since cleaning out my closet when I was having trouble with the snare, I'm that unrealistic prayer answered, and I'ma get you jacked up like you're trying to fix a flat when you struggle with despair.
Another double or triple. Old car jacked up. I'm going to get you jacked up. Like you're trying to fix a flat. When you struggle with the spare tire. Or when you struggle with despair.
I'm that unrealistic prayer answered. And I'm going to get you jacked up. Like you're trying to fix a flat. When you struggle with
despair. He's still talking about putting up a tire. All right. do you see?
I'll never forget if you turn your back on me now.
RIP Proof. That's what's up, man. That's what's up. Always got proof in my back. I'm gonna need a boost in my pack, man. All y'all little niggas out there, though, they keep on coming at M for real. Stop letting your boys put a battery in your back, man, making you think that you can mess with this dude, because you can't. Sorry, you can do anything in life. Sorry, let me say that again, because this is an inspirational song. You can do anything in life that you put your mind to, but fuck with M. Do that at your own risk.
My face in the hole, homie, I'm calling on you cause I think I'm slow, I'm starting to lose faith in it, so give me that infinite moment. Face in the cold,
that's tight. Hold on, that's tough, man. He letting them know, man. You know, you still motivate me to do things the right way, man. That's tight. And I'm still looking toward you to help me get through this. Give me some motivation.
In my bag, and I know that I always have proof in my bag. I caught your proof because I knew for a fact. My face in the hole, homie, I'm calling on you cause I think I'm slowly starting to lose faith in it, so give me that infinite moment. Face in the cold, insane with the flow. Fake fans let the two days of the show. Let heartbeats loop, produce hate in my soul. Playing vocals 2 days in a row. True statement, hate to go down this road, but there's only one.
Fake fans left you, two-faced at the show. You sang with the flow, fake fans left you, two-faced at the show. Let heartbeats loop, produced hate in my soul. You talking about 5 heartbeats? Because they had a whole lot of fake fans too, and they tried to separate the whole union that they had in the 5 heartbeats. Somebody let me know in the comments below if he's talking about the 5 heartbeats in this joint right here. I think he's talking about the 5 heartbeats. Walking this bitch with loose change? Because all my dues paid. But this booth's taking its toll. Like the toll booth when you're trying to get out of Maryland and go into Virginia and they always want to charge you goddamn $7 just to go over their punk ass bridge. Joint feel like it's wiggling when you go over the joint anyway. So they probably do need the money, my God. But okay. Alright. Alright, this ain't gonna be no long joint. Let's go.
Give me that infinite moment. Face in the cold, insane with the flow. Fake fans left to 2 days of the show. Let heartbeats loop, produce hate in my soul. Playing vocals 2 days in a row. Statement hate to go down this road, but there's only one route to cross this bridge. So I'm walking this bitch with boot chains, cause all my dues paid, but this boost taking its toll. But it's never too late to start a new beginning. That goes for you too. So what the fuck you gonna do? Use the tools you're getting.
It's never too late, bruh. It's never too late. I don't care what they say. Charlie Murphy. Y'all know Charlie Murphy? R.I.P. Charlie Murphy. Charlie Murphy didn't get into comedy, didn't step foot on a stage and try his hand at comedy until he was 42 years old. 41 or 42 years old. Just saying, it's never too late, man. Reinvent yourself. If it didn't work before, try it another way, man, but just go hard. Keep that same mentality that I ain't gonna stop until I get what I want out of life, man. You might not even know what you want out of life, but don't quit, man. Don't quit. This song is heavy as hell, bro. I love the message in this joint, man. This is tough.
Road, bridge,
taking its toll.
Too late to start a new beginning.
that goes for you. So what the fuck you gonna do? Use the tools you're getting. Use the tools. Use the card to doubt is an excuse for you to not do shit with him. I used to play a loser victim till I saw the way Proof was driven. Another shout out to Proof. A shout out to Proof, man. You can't say I grew up in poverty, so I don't have the same opportunities as everybody else. Nah, damn that, man. Go harder. Because when you go harder, you train harder. By the time it's time to compete with other people, you have an edge. Because they already had something given to them, and they was in a better situation. They didn't have the same the heat, that steam in their soul, man. That goes for you. Proof was driven. I found my vehicle and I haven't ran out of gas yet. And when they stack decks, turn handicaps into assets. Fanny packs, hourglasses. If time was on my side, I'd still have none to waste. Man, in my younger days, that dream was so much fun to chase. It's like I'd run in place with a shit dangled in front of my face. Oh my God. Oh my Christ, you feel like you're chasing the same thing forever and ever and ever, but you're making no ground. As a matter of fact, you're moving backwards. Because one thing happens, then another thing happens, man. I've been stacking my chips to buy equipment for this studio. And yet, we always making fun of people who are over a certain age, but they always at the studio or in the studio or trying to be a creative, man. We fall victim to the trap so much that we think that if you don't have a 9-to-5 job, you fooling yourself. Stop chasing those dreams, bruh. Because if you were supposed to meet them dreams already, you would have met them 5-10 years ago. Stop. We got to stop bringing each other down like that, man. Just because we don't see their vision. What the hell is that, bruh? I hate that, man. Like, this right here is dope. This right here is dope. And 9 times out of 10, if you ever start a venture, you ever start a business or something, don't go being all pissed off at your friends and your family members for not supporting you. Don't be pissed off at them. Don't post nothing all slick on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook talking about, y'all don't support me, man, if y'all, or just try to, you know, I hate when family members don't support you, but they always want you to support them. Nah. They're going to support you when it's time to support you. And if they don't, you got the whole world right there to support you, bruh. The whole world. What percentage of friends and family do you think are checking out my reaction videos? Not that much. Probably less than 1%. On Facebook, I got probably like 1,400 followers on Facebook. Friends on Facebook. And these are friends and family, man. People I went to school with. They don't come and check out my damn YouTubing. Give a damn about that. Now, when I reach a certain status, all of them are going to be right there. Like, man, what you doing? Put me on. Won't you talk about this? Won't you do this? Nah. Because I didn't need you to get to this level. I don't need you to go past this level. Because I believe in myself, bruh. That's all I'm saying, man. Stop using these excuses to not do a damn thing. Continue to chase whatever you feel is necessary, bro. And I haven't ran out of gas yet. When they stack decks, turn handicaps into assets. Handicaps, hourglasses. If time was on my side, I'd still have none to waste. Man, in my younger days, that dream was so much fun to chase. It's like I'd run in place with a shit dangled in front of my face. But how do you keep up the pace and the hunger pangs once you've won the race? Woo! That cool exhaust is cooling off because you don't got... That's heavy too. How do you keep up that same hunger after you've eaten? It's hard. It's very hard. Extremely hard. You become complacent real quick. Damn right, bruh. Once you reach your goal, go even harder. That was Eminem's Believe, man. That, whew, god damn, bruh. That's what we doing, M? That thing was awesome, man. All I will say is this. When you run your race like it's track and field, bruh. You're not racing anybody else but yourself, your own time. You know your time. You know what works for you. I believe, do you still believe, was aimed at himself? Like, I haven't seen, is there a video to this joint? But I would believe that he's talking to himself the whole time. Like, bro, you going to use these excuses that you grew up in, you know, the bad side of Detroit? Your mom and your dad wasn't supportive, all like that. Friends and family didn't believe in you. They looked at you, you're white boy in the black sport. You going to quit or what? I mean, you got everything against you. Why not quit? Go get you a job, man. Work for a Fortune 500 company. He could have probably did that easily. I mean, easily. Went to college, did things the right way, the right way. But if he did, we wouldn't have this art right here, man. Sorry for my ranting, guys. This joint was dope. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments below. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do so out the door, man. I'll see y'all next time. Peace.